Peace, peace. What's up to the fam out there? I want to appreciate everybody pulling up on us, coming to tap in with us on this Taco Tuesday. You dig what I mean? At this time, we want to look down and make sure we hit the like button. We also want to make sure that we share the video out. We also want to make sure that it's imperative that we share the video out, get the message out. You know, I kind of want to talk to y'all. We kind of go over something like that today. You know, about us getting serious as we move on and also being conscious of what's taking place around us. You feel me? But I ain't hit a boy, y'all, man. We're going to turn this bitch up, man. We got a great show today, man. We're going to go through some things, man. We might go through some games. You understand me? But you can choose, lose, stay confused, man. Make sure y'all on that like button, like I say. And make sure y'all share the video out to all your social media platforms. Turn up.
Can I tell my side of the street, nigga? Yeah. Can I tell my side? On the block from 9 to 5, we getting paper. In the middle of that jungle with that burner on me. For them long nights, we cry cause we had nothing. Look, I just want that money. Stuff them honey from me. My partner lost his mind when he switched sides. Now he crossed the line. But I just want that bread, and niggas want me dead. But fuck about what they said, I'm getting fucked away. It's like they want to take from me. Ever since that I came, they put dirt on my name. In public, they don't say nothing. Cause they know I'm with this shit. This 40 came with a dick. Came up from nothing, from that 2 piece of chicken. But niggas, I love, they hate the fact that I'm getting rich. But what goes around, comes around. Gotta watch my back cause they plotting to gun me down. I'm going through this day after day. I can't be real with you, bitches. I wouldn't care for my nigga. It's funny how people change on you. And it's the story of my life. Cross my heart and hope to die. And I,
hey,
I'ma keep it gangsta to the day I die. And I, can never be a snitch without no paperwork. They telling lies. And nigga, this time. Oh, I'm pulling up his homicide, I'ma shut it down. And I know they gon' hate on 3-4 whenever they think they be playing crazy. But fuck that little 380 F&N in my jeans. When I unload, shoot this bitch and aim it. Yeah, let's fuck who how he came and hope they hide it from me. And bitches, I'm a sign when I get loud. Just don't testify. Niggas plot on me, get shot in they sleep. Solo mission, I'm gone. Give a fuck who rock with 3. All I got is me. I did this shit on my own. They say wrong. That nigga did it. Niggas ain't getting it like they say they live. Sound like a bitch in some messy whole business. Won't catch me riding with a messy whole whip. It's a collision. Love my religion. Elijah Muhammad, tell Allah I'm with it. Due to the fact that my soul is so wicked. Break on a bitch, I got hoes on restriction. And I'ma keep it gangsta till the day I die. And I can never be a snitch without no paperwork. They telling lies. A nigga this time. Oh, I'm pulling up his homicide. I'ma shut it down. And I know they gon' hate on chief whatever.
Turn this motherfucker up, man. How y'all feeling out there? Yeah, sure. We in the mix. Who in the building? Who in this motherfucker? Want to appreciate everybody pulling up. T. Christopher, what up, though?
the GOAT. Shout out to T Crisp in the building. Hoodie Cello in the building. He said, I'm here for it. She hoisted. Thicker than the snicker. That boy from Florida in the building. Carrie Bay, what up, though? Engine Gal in the motherfucking building. Keith Kyle, what up, though, family? I see you. Indian Carter in the building. Lil TD, what's up with it? What's up with it, youngster? Chief Kokomo in the building. In the real way, representing Louisiana. Country boy. Brown Hawk in it, hope. Sue Sia, the weather woman. Nikki Sunflower. No Sellout. Shout out to the homie No Sellout, man. Got me smoking good over here, man. Yeah, y'all want to hear the call? Man, I got so much shit, man. Shout out to No Sellout. That nigga. Man, I got so much shit I haven't even went through it. I ain't even tasted everything. This nigga didn't motherfucking me. Y'all remember Boston George and Diego? Yeah, that nigga there on some motherfucking Boston George Diego shit. Yeah, that nigga think he Boston George, man. We got all kind of flavors and shit. What's this? Edibles? Fucking with them edibles the other day, man. I tell you, I had a whole day planned out, man. I went out and made reservations. And I had, because I've been courting this one chick for a while, man. We went out and had reservations and shit. You know, she a good girl, come from a two-parent household. They grew up in the suburbs. Yeah, they don't really, you know, they ain't really in and out of that other shit. Family, good, wholesome Christians and shit like that, man. And, you know, we had been talking, man, and I was going just about to meet the parents. We getting a little serious, man. And I say, man, I'm going to take her out on a date. Fucked around, and I had ended up picking up the package. And I'm so wired up, I done motherfucking me gave her a piece of the chocolate bar. Yeah, that nigga think a nigga don't know he got mushrooms in the chocolate. Yeah, that nigga got mushrooms in the chocolate, man. Mushrooms infused with the weed in the chocolate, man. Bitch say, you don't feel that? I said, huh? She said, you don't feel that? I said, feel what? She said, feel like the water rising. I said, huh? Bitch say it feel like the water rising. And motherfucker say, I will never forget you. I say, what the fuck is going on? That motherfucker thought we was Leonardo DiCaprio on Titanic. Bitch say we sinking. She say the water bitch say the water rising. Bitch say, don't let go. Whatever you do, don't let go. I say, bitch, we ain't on no motherfucking iceberg. This ain't the Titan. You better get your motherfucking ass up. These folks waiting on us. That motherfucker say, you hear that? I say, hear what? She say, my heart beating fast than a motherfucker. I said, man, hell nah, man. Come on, man. We got shit to do, man. I done put on these clothes and shit. You know what I'm saying? Me, these people waiting on us, man. We end up at the emergency room. You know, her family and them come up there. I met a dad, a pastor, shit like that. I said, this ain't the way that I thought this shit was going to go. Now they think I got their daughter and all type of shit. Now I might not be the nigga for her and shit. Fucking with this nigga, no sellout. He think a nigga ain't know he got mushrooms in the chocolate. Could have warned a nigga. What's this shit right here, too? This nigga gave me some shit called Super Chill. Super Chill. But the motherfucker ain't got no chill. And, you know, I feel like I'm a vet. So I take the motherfucker to the head. Man, that shit had me so fucked up. But shout out to the homie, No Shit Like, man. Urban Fruit, man. Y'all go over there and tap in with the guy. I had, man, there's so much shit in the damn bag. I ain't even went through everything. And I fucked around and ate that goddamn candy the other day. That shit fucked me up. I ain't want to hit no weed, no nothing. I ate by like 3 ice cream bars. I'm in that hole trying to come down. And the bitch tripping, so I don't want to tell everybody I'm high too. The motherfucker put me on the stretcher in there. Get to trying to take my vitals and shit like that. I'm like, bitch, we got... Bitch, I'm like, call the laws right now, 911. I say, bitch, we got dope in the house. Wait, call the laws and tell them come well. Bitch, somebody tell the laws, come get me. I can't breathe. Bitch, you, hey. Bitch, we got dope in the house. We ain't got ain't no motherfucking laws coming over here. Bitch, we got dope in the house. Ain't no, Fuck you mean? Man, we got firearms and all hell no, bitch. You ain't no shit. We start trying to call the baby daddies and shit to get a hold of them, tell them come get the kids and shit like that. One ounce, we got a hold of one of them mama and, you know, hey, man, one of them wife call, one of the baby daddy wife call, say, we can make arrangements if need be. Hey, man, talking about he out of town, he a truck driver. Listen, man, that motherfucker about to faint. That motherfucker thought she was Rose on Titanic. That motherfucker say, whatever you do, don't let go. I say, bitch, fucking with this nigga Urban Fruity. Fuck my motherfucking weekend up, man. What's up with it? Liz Robinson in the building. Indian Carter in there, ho. Northern Bell. What up, though? Khalil Jenkins, turn on one time. Mike Easton, I see you, family. Desmond Kirkendall. Kiki, little six ass. What's up with it, homegrown? Best media in the building. World and Thunder, the homie Be Smooth in the building. Turn up one time. Star 3 a.m. Shalom. What's up, Miss T? Turn up one time. All right, I can't get everybody. Joe 47 in the building. Coke in the building. Honey Covered Roses. Ohio Player in the building. I'm born here. Turn on one time. Shooting wind. I see you. Man, if I missed y'all, goddamn Dark Chief 305 in the house. Ebony in the building. Yoad in the building. OG Dunna Grant in the building. Joe Jack, I see you. David Scott the Third in the building. All right, turn up. Can't get everybody, man. Shout out to you. If I missed your name. It's all love, though. Kiki say she want to try that edible. I don't know, Kiki. I don't know if you can handle that. You know, you kind of small. I don't know if you can handle that. That shit knock a nigga dick in the dirt. I'm sitting here talking about be strong. Bitch told me, hey, whatever you do, don't let go. Bitch, you better get your motherfucking ass up. I done paid for these goddamn reservations. Pay for these motherfucking reservations. These folks down there texting my phone. They waiting on us. She say just the nibble. Yeah, that's all your ass gonna get, goddamn. Mac Dunn, what's up with it? Turn it one time. Oh, D Hayden in the building. I see you. Man, let me tell you. Hey, that nigga know I ain't lying. Look. Watch this here. Just answer me this, bro. Just drop it in the chat. Urban Fruit. Are y'all putting mushrooms in the chocolate? Just drop it in the chat, Urban Fruit. Are y'all putting mushrooms in the chocolate? Is that what's happening? He say them edibles that have your ass in stars. Yeah, I don't like that. I like to control my own high. I like to control my own high and shit. Shout out to Cutting Junior in the goddamn building. Man, we got a today we got a good show, man. We're gonna go over a few things. I also want to say, man, time out. Hey, did y'all watch that Nina Boy and Bosco fight? Did anybody watch that Nina Boy and Bosco fight? Trash. We're gonna move on. We ain't gonna stay on it too long, but Nina Boy went out like a straight hoe. Oh, man, when clout chasing goes wrong. You know, man, it be different, bro. This internet be a motherfucker, man. You be having niggas out here, they be want to be a star, want to be famous. And, you know, these niggas willing to do whatever to get that shine, man. So this guy, bro, nobody even knew him. He clout chased his way to get in a fight with Bosco. And we're going to keep it real. We know if people been following, you seen Bosco fight Gunzo, rest in peace Gunzo. And now, you know, that wouldn't even really know. You know what I'm saying? Nobody was looking at these niggas like the second coming of Mayweather or no shit like that, right? But then you had this guy Nina boy, he come out, he talking this, catch this game, though. Say, man, out here on this black top, man. And, you know, real nigga out here, man. East Coast, man. You know, crib, big crib and all this type of shit. And, you know, he gonna beat this person up. And nigga had a lot to say about a lot of people on the internet. And you know, he telling nigga, this is my time to shine. And you know, and man, nigga got out there, bro, caught that pussy. Ain't no other way around it. Nigga caught that pussy. And nigga, you look bad. They tan his ass up. I'm talking about everywhere you look. This nigga then went live. They tore his ass up. And y'all know his excuse. His excuse is that they only paid him $280. Well, if they gave you $280, you robbed them folks. You robbed the shit out of them folks. You robbed everybody that was looking. The nigga say he ain't tripping. If you bought a ticket, take it up with 11-11 promotions because he ain't getting no money. Nah, bro. You got to understand people that was there to support you, they paid their money to come and support you. You don't turn around and say, well, I ain't getting no money, so I couldn't fight for y'all. No, you ain't fight because you caught that pussy. You ain't want to get knocked out. Nigga, ain't nobody. Listen, you know what type of hoe got to be up in you, man. Nigga's going down and I ain't going to fight. I just, man, nigga caught that pussy, man. They tore his ass up. And it's deserving it. Now, he got a lot of followers, a lot of subscribers. He bought a lot, too. But he got a lot of subscribers off of about the fight, Bosco. But most of the people was trolling him. And now it's even worse. Nigga caught that Jack Matt, man. But we moving on. That was just a little this weekend. That was just it. Hey, no sellout. Urban Fruit. He say he just step back in. Hey, I got a question, bro. You'll probably have to rewind it to, you know what I'm saying? See what we just talking about. But I got a question, though. No, Urban Fruit. Do y'all put mushroom in y'all chocolate? In that little chocolate bar? Or y'all put mushrooms in that chocolate bar? He said, I rewind it. Hey, did y'all put mushrooms in that damn chocolate bar? Yeah, man, y'all go watch it. The fight is on YouTube, though, man. Trash, trash, trash. And y'all go tell Nina boy ass up. Run that nigga ass off of YouTube. Run that nigga off the block. When clout chasing, when capping. Catch it, though, while he on his black top, yo. And you got to be a real nigga and count that pussy. Fuck out of here, nigga. All right. Let's turn up. What we gonna do? All right, so we got a good build. Before we get into the build, I want to share my screen, goddamn. Before we get in the build. Can I put this motherfucker on here? Hold on, let me see something, man. I might download something on here. I want to show y'all something. Two things I want to show y'all. Shout out to the homie Back for What's Mine in the building. All right, yeah, I want to show y'all something. So remember, right? Y'all remember all that shit y'all was talking about the podcast. Remember we said, hey man, we gonna have the podcast coming. And then I said, I don't know, bro. I don't know if I can do it. I'm kind of getting cold feet and shit like that. And you know, y'all convinced me, nah, you should go and do it. Think it'll be a good look. And so we here now, nigga. All right, so I want to show y'all something. Let me take this down, share my screen. Yeah, man, that dating came. All right, turn up. Hey, hold on. Let me go back. You can't really see it.
You know, to get up for the men.
Hey, women, what y'all know about these right here? What y'all know about these here? Make that pussycat purr. What y'all know about these? Because we damn sure got them.
Also, we have a panty vibrator as well, man. Y'all come tap in with us, man, at 12playground.com in the real, real way. We gone. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Tap in, vibrator, spin it out.
12 ways. All right, so check it out. Check it out. Okay, the super chill, the tree, you say the answer to the chocolate question. Ah, hey, y'all caught his ass. Yeah, this nigga caught his ass. Yeah, bitch ended up in the hospital, man. The motherfucker then took my vitals. I was in that hole. I'm in that hole knowing like I'm full of that heroin or something. This nigga didn't drop. Goddamn. He said, yes, the chocolate bar was mushroom infused. God, oh, it's on the package. Okay, all right. I ain't read the package. I just got the chomping down on that motherfucker. Next time, I might need to read the package. I need to see how many grams in this motherfucker. Yeah. I ain't even read the pack, goddamn. She said, I heard that make the coochie wet. Lord have mercy. What the hell is Kiki talking about? Kiki, that thing don't need no supplements. That thing don't need no supplements. That motherfucker don't need no supplements. Not at all. That motherfucker don't need no help. Oh, damn, where I was going. Oh, okay. Yeah, that part. Turn up. Hey, y'all, we have the store up. Freaky Friday. Friday gonna be crazy. You know what? We might have a winner today. We might do something today. Or y'all, we might wait till Friday. Or we might wait till Friday. Yeah, we might just wait to Friday. But before we get in, I do want to show y'all something. I got a question.
Do you mind if I give you some of mine? 12 play. Do you mind, baby?
Do you mind? Turn it one time, goddamn.
Give you some of mine. 12 play. Okay, here we go.
All right, turn up. My bad. Hold up.
I'm trying to figure out, do y'all mind out there? All right, this is what we doing right here. All of the talking and shit, we done with all of the talking. Hey, what the hell Peter do? Damn, y'all should have let me tag ass up. What the hell Peter did? Oh. All right, so we're going to come over here, man. So these are some of the items that we have right here. We got the Rose dildo, both sides. We have the we got the Rose right here. There's 10% discount on the man. We got the suction Rose. We got the again, what's Colin did though, but we also have the panty vibrators. And we got the panty vibrators, and they're only $27. I know y'all been seeing like a lot of commercials and shit like that, a lot of shit on the internet. Motherfuckers been playing with them vibrators. They going out to eat. They going on vacation. They going to the movies. They on a dinner date, and they playing with the toys, man. So this right here is Bluetooth. What you do is you put it on the Bluetooth on your phone, fellas, and while y'all out in the bot, you turn that motherfucker on the ass. You turn it on, and if that pussy really sensitive, you got a motherfucking ass. Y'all be looking out. We got the podcast coming soon. We do have a podcast coming soon, and it's going to be on OnlyFans. It's going to be on OnlyFans, the podcast, because we can't do what we want to do over here. Every show not going to be nudity, but it is going to be nudity. We will be dealing with the body. We will be dealing with the human body. It is sex education. We got a lot of different things. I mean, we're going to have witches in there. We're going to have motherfuckers showing you how to do sex magic, sex rituals. We're going to have motherfuckers in there talking holistic wellness. We're going to have motherfuckers in there talking about how to properly please your spouse. We're going to have people in there talking about the lifestyle. I say that. I say the lifestyle. If you know, you know, goddamn, when I say the lifestyle. But yeah, it's just different vacation, man, different scene. We do want to get somebody out to go play with the toys, but you're going to have to come back and tell us about the experience, though. Yeah, so we'll do that. Friday, we might have like a little south opening. You know what I'm saying? We might pop out Friday on Freaky Friday, man, just to turn up one time. But the website is 12playplayground.com, 12playplayground.com. Make sure y'all come support and come shop with us. Y'all talked all this shit. We got the vibrator. They ain't nothing but $20 too, goddamn. They ain't number $20 too. So y'all come fuck with the kid in the real way. All right, let's get to the bill. Let's get to the bill, goddamn. Ah, look at Callie. Callie, you're a little bad. I'ma stop thinking you innocent. You ain't no goddamn church girl. I'ma stop thinking your ass. Well, the lifestyle I was talking about was, well, they could come from a poly lifestyle, because we will have people in here talking about poly lifestyle and how it works for them, the pros and cons for them. You know, those will be the type of subjects, but I watch this, Kylie. The one I was talking about was a swingers lifestyle. Kylie, I was talking about swingers lifestyle. Now what's up? Joe 47, I'm saying church girl. Now, there ain't no church girl. She ain't no church girl. She just know how to play it off. Ebony say no cock rings. Fellas, are y'all niggas out there wearing the cock rings? Fellas, y'all into the cock rings? Y'all in the... Look at Peter, the white guy. He's in top cat high as fuck. Bitch, I ain't even smoke yet, stupid ass nigga. Say, shout out to King Sinetta. Shout out to Sinetta. All right, y'all. Remember I said I wanted to see what Peter was. Okay, y'all can kill him now. Bye, Peter. Shout out to the house. Shout out to HOK, Peter, in a real way. Oh, but you about to die now. They're going to kill you, Peter. Peter? Peter, they're going to kill you, bro. Nigga say, oh, wow. Fellas, y'all into the cock rings? Y'all, I didn't know. I ain't know. Oh, you know, I could get some of them, they something like, what they call them, like bangos, them hoes you put on, it's like the ring, you put it on, and then it come with like a little bullet, like a little baby bullet. I don't like that shit, though. Yeah, I don't like all that, though, the vibrating shit on me and all that. Yeah, I ain't, nigga, I ain't finna, yeah. I don't like all that old vibrating shit on me. That shit knocked the algorithm out. Yeah, that shit fuck with my algorithm. That shit fuck with my algorithm, goddamn. What's up with the kill 314? Kelly, you just missed it. Kelly, you just missed it. Kelly say, two of my former mentors are sex researchers in BDSM. Okay. She said, I used to study human sexuality. Extremely fascinating stuff. Wow. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say. Kelly, they say, go get some, she say, blast them balls off. hey, watch this here. Copper skin say, he the goddamn ring. Indian Carter say, what the fuck is a cock ring? This nigga say, he need a bean. Turn that nigga say, I just popped a Tesla, now I'm feeling electric. Nah, I never heard of Amanda American. Nah, I ain't never heard of her. What she do, homegrown? What she end up doing? He say, niggas gonna be like Inspector Gadget. He say, what's scat? Yeah, what's scat, Kathy? Do I need to drop the link? She said one of them had a friend into scat. I never heard of that. That was a bridge too far for me. I was looking at her sideways. Kelly, I need to drop the link. Kelly, can you come up and talk to us and tell us a little more? Dead gang said it's an experience. Dead gang, you know what? And this nigga talking about blasting balls off. Lord have mercy. Look at Peter. Even when you slander us. Peter, get your bitch ass away from here, ho. She said, you sure you want to know? Yeah, I want to know. Nikki say, what's cat? Oh, eating feces. Oh, okay. All right. Yeah, I heard of this shit. Junior say, I ain't sticking my cock in nothing but pussy and tonsils. Fuck a cock ring. Yeah, who's this? Is this shit? Ebony, what the hell are you into? Cock rings and leathers and leather straps and shit. Ah, she said, oh no, we good. She said she a nine. What the hell is that? What that mean? Kelly, what that mean? Kelly, what's a nine? Kelly, what's a nine? What that mean? She just popped a Tesla, now she gone electric. All right. All right. He said, that's how them Europeans got you, nigga. They slapped them cock rings on you and stole the land. Ah, she said, I dabbled around. She said, yeah, there's some pretty out there stuff I got exposed to when I was hanging with people from the BDSM community. Fierce scholars, though. Some of the best in the country. She said, fierce scholars, some of the best in the country, I bet. So, Kelly, When you got into this BDSM, when you was hanging around these people from the BDSM community, did you take anything from that you used in your personal life, for the BDSM and all of that, all of this knowledge from these top scholars, best in the country? Did you take some of that? Did you incorporate it into your personality? Kelly, did you incorporate some of those things in your personality? Ah, it's concept say take your socks off and do what, Keith? He said he followed instructions. What next? She said it's true. The kind of people who turn their houses into sex dungeons on Saturdays. Oh, okay. So niggas out here got real life sex dungeons. He say, Kiki say, place your feet in my hand and I'll take care of the rest. Carrie say, the picture of in my head is crazy. Geek Freaks Encyclopedia. What's up with the Gulf Coast? She said, of course, I was doing the research as well. Okay. One of the best in the country, huh, Kelly? Okay. One of the best in the country. Peter say, drop the link. All right, Peter, I'm going to drop the link and then we're going to get to our bill. We got to go to get your bill. Come here, let me slap you around, bitch. So you can get your punk ass up out of here, you troll ass nigga. Bullshit ass nigga. All right, Peter, bitch, the link in the chat, ho. Uh-oh. Go on, tell the truth, then. She said, I seen the sex dungeon on Ghost Hunters. Oh, man, I thought you had some good shit. Thought you was going to sit around the corner. She said, it's a known thing that people in the BDSM community tend to be extremely intelligent and well-adjusted emotionally, contrary to popular belief. Well, let me ask you this, Kelly. Are you still in the BDSM community? Hey, what you want, bitch? What the fuck you want, bitch?
Who you calling the bitch, man?
Calling you a bitch, nigga. What the fuck you want?
That all you got, man? That all you got? Okay. Come here. Shanzo was on Sunday. All
right. Let me get this bitch away from here. All right, hoe, get the fuck away from here. She said, how I missed the alert. Okay. All right, so we're going to go into the bill. All right, we're going to go get into the bill. Since Kat is scared to come up, goddamn, and tell us about this. Kat, you ain't got 5 minutes to come tell us about this, Kylie. I tell y'all, right? I used to do passion parties. If y'all familiar with passion parties, it's like a girls' night out. I used to do passion parties. Shout out to Crystal, goddamn. She said y'all hit the goddamn like button.gov. What's up with it, Razzle Dazzle? Turn up one time. Raz in the building. Yeah, that hoe don't need, that hoe can't even speak proper English. She's into tantric sex now since I was 19 years old. Lord have mercy. Woo! Hey, shit. I mean, goddamn, one's mind get to wondering. Yeah, she's trained, fellas. She's trained in Tantra School of Thought. You know, it just can't help but make the mind wonder. Fellas, y'all don't leave me out here by my motherfucking self. Fellas, she say she's trained, skilled. Profession, perfected the craft. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, goddamn. She's trained and skilled. Oh, Kylie, do you train others? I mean, you went out and got the knowledge. Do you train others, Kylie? And nigga Vito said, man. Joey said, Jesus, skilled in the art of fucking on you. Snatching your soul. Carrie said, is that sex magic shit? Yeah, that shit there. Look at him. He's what teach what he got there. He's what teach what. Kylie, we might need you to do some missionary work, Kylie. Kylie, we might need you to do missionary work and go back to the tribe and teach the others. We might need you to go back to the tribe and teach the others, goddamn. Missionary work. Look at him, Kylie. You got everybody jumping now. He said, man, what the fuck is going on in here? She said, inquiring minds want to know. Superior said, Kama Sutra. Yeah, sir, into that. He say, Nikki say, Tantra 6 is good, goddamn. Khalil say, that's some mythical sex. Kai, he say, I've been looking for an instructor. That young man trying to get instructed. See, I thought y'all knew that I never hid that from the public. Well, Kylie, look, oh shit, they got Ken in here. Yeah, Ken watching. She in here trying to snatch a nigga's soul. What's the song? She wanna dive in it. He wanna dive in it. Snatch his soul. Yeah, they and that bitch talking about put your mind on Jesus. Close your eyes and put your mind on Jesus. Warrior King say, you got to get that woman from Kendra G channel. She says she suck it with joy and gratitude. She wheels things into existence with the power of the P. Hey, Warrior King, send it to my IG. DM it to me. I'm going to go check them out. I'm looking for people like that. Send it to my IG and I'm going to go find her. She says she do what? She said, I don't need to snatch a soul. I elevate one soul. Check it out. Kelly, now you know motherfucker want to ride that ride. Kylie, you out here advertising, goddamn. You know motherfucker want to ride that ride. Now you got motherfucker want to ride the ride. Yeah. Now you got nigga want to, you know, now nigga curious. Yeah, nigga Curious George around this hoe now. I'm trying to see what that be like. Anyways, we got a good show today. Somebody killed Peter again. This nigga, this bitch will not go away. Bitch, get away from here. Get your funky ass down the street, ho. Where Shrug go? I ain't even see the nigga. Oh, okay. He got his trunks on. That nigga out here in his trunks. He got his swimming trunks on. That nigga got his swimming trunks on, goggles. He talking about drop the link and don't run. Bitch, ain't nobody got time to play with you. Peter, what you want, you stupid ass bitch? There go the link, ho. Come on, bro. We finna get in. We got two videos. Well, really three that we're gonna break down. Hey, y'all seen that weak ass video that nigga Taz did the other day? I couldn't find it. He took it down or something. I was finna tear his ass up. Nigga come out here with lookership and no understanding on American history. See, what niggas got to understand is they created a whole lane for black people. They created a whole doctrine about what happened in America for black people. And black folks out here going with it. That nigga put up Sitting Bull and shit like that. Talking about, is that your people? I'm going to help you niggas out, right? I'm going to help you niggas out and show y'all how to do this shit. If you look up, if you talking about Sitting Bull and all these pictures of these pictures of these plain Indian niggas pulling, you have to, I tell you what, go back to the first treaty with America with these people and see what year that is. If you're going to talk about Indians and who looking like who, then why aren't you going by the first contact tribes, the people that they met when they first got here? Why would you go with somebody that they met in the 1860s, 1880s and shit? Just right there, you know what I'm saying? Let a nigga know that you're going to be two steps behind when you fucking with somebody who know what they're doing. I don't know what eye these niggas looking at this shit from. It's not about lookership. Only black folks do lookership. That's why they think they black. Only black folks do lookership or get caught up in the lookership game. Oh, yeah, that shit there, that was trash, that was weak, that was real low level. And a nigga would get their ass mopped. What, white boy?
Pop cuts.
Man, say, what the fuck do you want, nigga?
Do your people proud and don't run from the white guy this time, okay?
Be brave. Bro, listen, you ain't got nothing else to do.
Peter. Be brave, okay?
Peter.
Now, question. Bitch, do you think Jabari's a creep?
Do you care? Why you worry about another man?
Do you think Jabari's a creep?
Why the fuck do you care?
You can't answer. Okay. Do you believe Shandor when she said he's a creep?
Why the fuck do, what business do you have with that? Are you from the Ku Klux Klan?
Why are you helping him? Why are you slandering Sanetta and Jabari? Why are you slandering Sanetta? Why?
You a stupid ass nigga. You know that?
Why is she lying on them?
You a dumb ass nigga. You know that, Peter?
And why'd you broadcast it? Why'd you let her lie on them?
Listen. Let me say this here, Peter.
Yes, who? Just answer the question.
Let me say this, Peter. Do I think Jabari a creep?
Yeah.
No, I don't. I don't think he a creep.
Okay. So why do you let Sean Joy slander him on your channel?
Listen, I say this here.
Why didn't you challenge her on it?
What the fuck do I got to do with it? If somebody feel how they feel, everybody entitled to their own opinion.
Do you realize how dangerous that is when women lie on them?
Listen, I'm not trying to call them creeps.
You don't realize that, no? You don't realize that, no?
I don't realize it. I don't. Okay? I realize everybody entitled to their own opinion.
Slander, man.
What the fuck do a white boy? Listen, bro. What do you have to do with anything? You're a white boy. You're a colonizer. What the fuck you got to do with anything? How many niggas you run this year?
How many unarmed black people you shot this year?
Get over yourself. Get over that bullshit.
How many unarmed black people you shot this year, white boy?
Why are you slandering? Why are you slandering? Why do you have slandering on the black people?
How many black people you killed this year?
Zero.
How many niggas you hung?
Zero.
How many niggas you hung? Ku Klux Klan. Zero. How many slaves y'all had on your plantation?
Why you running from? Why you running?
Bitch, ain't nobody running, though. Stay how many slaves you had on your plantation, Peter?
Why are you letting a fellow black man be slandered on your channel?
Man, I don't give. I'm not no black man, and I don't give a fuck about black people. How about that?
Why you let Jabari be slandered?
People, nigga.
Why you let Jabari on your channel?
Listen to
why
me.
Why you let him be slandered on your
listen
channel?
Listen to me. I don't give a fuck about no Jabari, okay?
You don't?
I don't, nigga.
Okay, so if he's a creep, according to Sean Jordan,
bitch, shut up. I just told you I don't
think
he's a creep.
Why did he say he was a cool guy the next day?
Go ask her. What the fuck is you asking me for?
You got it on here. Come on.
Go ask her, you stupid ass white boy.
Where's
hey, listen, let me say get this, Peter. Shut the fuck up while I'm talking, bitch. Shut up, bitch, while I'm talking. That shit happened like 5 days ago. What the fuck exactly. Are you worried about it for? That shit happened like 5 days. What the fuck is you still? You ain't got you're nothing else going on in your life. You worrying about something happened a week ago?
If he's such a really? Creep, why did you say he was a creep?
Really, you dumb ass nigga. Fuck out of here, white boy. And let me say this here. I don't give a fuck about no European, no black European slave masters, colonizers, nigga. You out here talking about a damn Jabari. I don't give a fuck about no colonizer, slave master, nigga. The fuck is wrong with you? Anyway, moving on. All right, what my shit is. All right, fair use. We're gonna go through. I guess I'll just play the audio. We're going to go through this. They're teaching on the Gullah Geechee in the Africa diaspora. This is a conference. And so we're going to go through this here. Bitch ass nigga. You niggas is weird, bro. So y'all, the hook in this shit, right? Oh shit, let me do something. I want to show y'all the hook in this shit. And I guess I should have did something else too. Why we gonna go through this? Because there's a hook in it. Yes, ma'am. I got you, sweetheart. Thank you. Appreciate that. She hosted Miss Nikki. Let me turn it up for y'all.
And so I was thinking, okay, what's a good metaphor for this? Well, I thought of a Nazi spider. And I thought, well, let me just see Gullah Geechee culture as the body of the spider. And then the legs would be how you could begin here and see other echoes of the same kind of cultural phenomena elsewhere in the African diaspora. For example, in my first experience, and I'm going to show you some images so that you'll have a sense that I have some legitimacy. But the first time so I came to Gullah Geechee land, I went to the Fuske Island, and Mr. Thomas started to tell an animal story about big mass and critters. And I thought, oh, wow, those stories still exist. You know, I knew about Brer Rabbit, but I never heard anybody tell a Brer Rabbit story. I just read it about Brer Rabbit. Then I was in Ecuador on the Pacific coast of South America. And Juan Garcia, who was a wonderful researcher and storyteller, he was telling a Tio Conejo story, Brer Rabbit, Uncle Rabbit in Spanish. And he said that he had a visitor from Burkina Faso in West Africa. Juan started to tell him, to the man from Burkina Faso, his Tio Conejo story. And he paused to drink some water, and the man from Burkina Faso continued the same story. Every time I say that, I wish I'd been there. You know, I feel like I've been there. It gives me goosebumps. Because when was the last time an African found himself involuntarily on the Pacific coast of South America? The story was the same.
Y'all hear that? So now they finna go around. This is how you colonize niggas. Nigga come here talking about the Jabari. Jabari is a fucking colonizer. This is how you colonize niggas. So they came out and started saying, you know what? Niggas have a culture. And you know what? They cultures in Africa. Now, by the way, I want you to note this here, that the nigga who had the loudest voice in this was a white boy. A white boy came out and said, niggas got a culture. And that white boy name was Melville Herkovich, a white Jew. He came out and told niggas, niggas got a culture. And that culture is in Africa. One of the ways that they did it, they started seeing similarities on these different continents. And the same stories, the same songs. And yes, the songs happen to be Christian songs. Nigga was singing about Jesus. That's wild.
I thought that was just amazing. And so one could also tell Anansi stories. So the wisdom tales that continue to exist. Food ways. I was on St. Helena and I ate some red rice. I said, I know this flavor, but I've never been to St. Helena before. But I've eaten jollof rice in various places in West Africa. It was the same flavor. So I thought I would look at the culture as a, or the Gullah culture, as a jumping off place to talk about some elements of this global African diaspora. There's my title, From the Fusky Island to the Global African Diaspora. I knew that that the most African culture in the United States existed in these islands, but I didn't know anything. I did know, however, I knew Herman Blake. And Herman Blake said, well, you gotta go to the Fusky Island. So I went to the Fusky Island. And what Herman said was, call Mr. Jake and he'll come get you. So I called Mr. Jake and he came and got me. And so he's crabbing as he's taking me to the Fusky Island on his boat. And he took me to this burglar's house, and that's where I stayed. And I was very struck when I saw her. She was eating in a bowl with a tablespoon, and she was eating grits and some fish and some sauce. And I thought, I've seen this scene before. I had seen women with their heads tied up eating out of a bowl with a tablespoon and eating fufu or toe or...
Y'all hear them? They eating fufu. This shit is crazy to me, bro. This shit is crazy because they saying, you know what? Y'all do the same thing them niggas in Africa do. Man, I ain't trying to disrespect or knock no African or nothing, man. I love Africans, bro. But keep it gangster, man. Niggas who be talking at the culture is the same, bro. I don't know if niggas ever been somewhere or like seen real Africans in real African culture. Have you ever seen an African eat? No, that's real, bro. I'm being honest. Have you ever seen an African eat? First off, nigga, growing up in the Indian house, nigga, you get your ass whooped for eating like that. You would get your motherfucking ass whooped for eating like that. Oh, niggas, listen, man, Nah, bro, you seen them people eat with their mouth wide open, man. them people eat with their hands. Oh, nah, bro, that shit, that man, ain't nobody in no motherfucking American culture doing no shit like that. You get your ass whooped for that. Do you see how ashy them folks' ankles and feet be? You will get your ass whooped in the Indian house if you ain't got no motherfucking lotion on. You running around this whole ashy. Nah, bro, listen, man. Nah, we not gonna do that type of shit, man. I remember I was at this place called Nando's. Nando's is, I think it's Portuguese. Don't let me get the line. But I think Nando's Portuguese. But Nando's is like real big on the other side of the world, family. Like, it's like a major spot. And if you ask me, they don't even put seasoning on their food. They just throw the meat on a fucking fire. Caveman shit. And then they put this little sauce. You know, around the world, they use salt. They don't use seasoning. They lay the meat in the sauce and all this type of shit in this. Nah, fuck that, nigga. Put some seasoning on my shit. But anyway, I was in Nando's, man, and it was hot than a bitch outside. So I said, hey, man, let me get a table on the inside. So I'm sitting down, and it was this African lady, and I guess it was her son. I don't know. He was younger. So, but first off, I noticed they sit with their legs wide open. Huh? They sitting with their legs wide open. And I mean, they was sucking this food down to the gristle. I mean, no home training, no motherfucking. And these ain't no broke Africans. I ain't talking about no, nah. I couldn't believe it. I said, ain't no motherfucking way in hell, nigga. Ain't no way in hell. And niggas be out here talking about the culture is the same. I saw you do the same thing that nigga did. Man, that nigga do a lot of shit I'd never do. You a motherfucking liar. That shit is an abomination in my house, nigga. Man, hell no. Nah. Nigga ain't getting away with no shit like that. Shout out to the homie, Two Chicks. Shout out to the homie, Two Chicks, goddamn, jumping in the Cash App. Shout out to the homie, Al, jumping in the Cash App with $50. Appreciate that, little fam. And shout out to the homie, Mo, goddamn, jumping in the Cash App with a dub. Appreciate that love in the real way. Hey, man, y'all go over there to 12playground.com, 12playground.com, bro, and go buy y'all one of them panty vibrators. Go get one of them panty vibrators, man. 12playground.com. Go get a panty vibrator, man. Take your girl out on a date. Fellas, where y'all at? Hey, can somebody drop the link? Teek say, nah, I'm not eating out the same bowl as everybody else. Come on, Teek. Talk about it. Them motherfuckers will sit down and then everybody eating with their hands. Teek, ain't no spoons. Motherfuckers taking scoops with their palms. Nigga get a palm full and nigga eating that hoe with two hands. Everybody out the same bowl. Nigga double dipping. Yeah, you know, Africans, they like to dig in their booty. Yeah, they're digging their nose, digging their booty right there. They don't ain't no shame in their motherfucking game. That shit ain't against no religion, though. You ain't breaking no codes or nothing when you... Yeah, nigga go right in his ass. No problem. It's life. Nigga go right in his ass, man, and go to... And keep talking, going by... Yeah. I don't even think America's digging their booty no more. Y'all be digging in y'all booty. I don't know. I don't really... Nah, you know what? I was in Atlanta... And we was at Target, and it was this nigga came out, man. Nigga just dug in his booty, nigga. And he looked back, and guess what? It was somebody standing back there looking at his ass. Caught your nasty ass. You must be a first or second genius. Yeah. That nigga must be a first or second genius or something. Y'all, I'm telling you, African nigga now, man, don't bring that old digging in your booty shit over here to America, man. All that hoe ass shit there, man. Y'all leave that big sandal ass shit feet. Y'all leave that shit over there in Africa. coming over here digging in your motherfucking booty, nigga. Don't know grown-ups digging their booty over here, nigga. Ho-ass nigga. Don't be around here with that shit, nigga. Take that bitch-ass shit back to Africa, nigga. Man, ain't no grown-up. Ain't nobody digging in their ass, nigga, over 6-7 years old, nigga. You over 6-7 years old, you shouldn't be digging in your motherfucking booty, nigga. Fuck you 32 years old out here digging in your ass still. You ain't broke that motherfucking cycle yet, nigga. Whole ass nigga playing in your ass. Let's walk.
Or futu or sadza or one of those African staples with the tablespoon and a bowl. So the image was familiar to me. Now, a colleague was supposed to go with me, but he said, somebody said that there would be snakes, and he said, oh, no, I'm not going. And I thought, oh, no, no snakes. And so this is Mr. Thomas. And he and his Bertha took me for a ride, and I saw a snake. That snake, I just, maybe the snake moved too fast, sorry. But I saw a snake, and I said, oh, there's a snake. And they didn't react. And I thought, oh, maybe that's like seeing a squirrel. No. Then I realized something else. You know, they talked funny, those people on Husky Island. Well, that's when I realized that I talked funny too. It took them a while to realize what I was saying about that snake. You're like, snake? Mr. Thomas, who had one eye and a bad leg, jumped out of the car, went around to the truck, got his gun, and killed the snake. So that was my role. Americans were going to Africa to look for ancestors. I was looking for adventures, not ancestors. Americans were going.
So, here you go, right here, you got to put.
Part of things. Well, I did too. And that's what I was mentioning when I was 19. I went to Cameroon. And I was welcomed home. And this is before African Americans were going to Africa to look for ancestors. I was looking for adventures, not ancestors. This was prior to Roots. And a man came to lunch and said, well, you're a Black American, yes. Well, that means your ancestors came from Africa. Well, I hadn't thought about ancestors at that point. And I hadn't thought about that. And I said, well, I don't know, I guess so. And he said, well, welcome home. Welcome to the source. And that was the beginning of my going to Africa.
Nigga say, welcome home, welcome to the source. Nigga tell him, you Black American. He said, yeah. He said, well, you from Africa. Welcome home, welcome to the source. Let me say this by you West African. Y'all ain't got shit in West Africa. Y'all ain't got a motherfucking thing in West Africa, nigga. You niggas still riding dirt roads. You niggas ain't got no motherfucking, you niggas can't flush no toilet around that hoe. You niggas ain't got clean running water or nothing. Nigga talking about the source. The source of what, nigga? The source of what? You hoes, they ain't even know how to put on motherfucking deodorant yet. You motherfuckers ain't even learned how to properly wash your ass, nigga. The source. Nigga, funky than a billy goat. You ain't even learned the science of antiperspirant. This nigga here, man. Y'all come get this nigga.
And that I belong there too. And that's part of my story. And that you can't tell the story of the Americas, certainly, without understanding the role of Africa in the Americas. So, first thing I think it's fundamental to know about the Americas is who was here. We know that there had been Native Americans, most of whom weren't even the Native. So let me give you some statistics. We are given the impression that the Americas was a European creation. But if you know the demographics of the creation of the Americas, it doesn't really make sense to see it as just a European creation. Of the 6.5 million people who crossed the Atlantic during the first 300 years of the existence of the modern Americas, 5.5 million people were African, 1 million came from Europe. That's pretty basic.
Homegrown, weird. That ain't tearing them down. Tell me why I lied it. Tell me why I lied it. Them niggas ain't got running water. What's a source of what? A source of colonization.
Nah, hell nah. That ain't tearing them down. We telling the truth. Africans don't wear deodorant. I don't know if you ever been to Africa, homegrown, or been around Africans. But Africans don't wear deodorant. Most West Africans are not even from West Africa.
Did everybody know that?
No, man.
Well, I learned that I was mad. You know, I had a PhD.
Well, I learned that.
So.
I will send it to you.
So, at the end of the 19th century, 12 to 15 million people had come from Africa to the Americas, all of the Americas, Chile to Canada.
12 to 15 million people came here from Africa. This is the creation of America, she say. 12 to 15 million came from Africa to America.
We are given the impression that African diasporas are not every place. African diasporas are every place in the Americas. Each of the countries of the Americas has at least one organized group of African descendants. And now, apparently a third of the population of the Americas is composed of African descendants. There are more than 200 million African descendants in the Americas. And we in the United States, we know we're the center of the world.
Over 200 million Africans in America. Wow.
And that the African diaspora speaks English, of course. Well, that's not true. There are more than 100 million Afro-Brazilians. So Portuguese is the first language of the African diaspora. First language of the African diaspora in the world. And the first... Brazil is second in African-descended populations after Nigeria. So there are more African descendants in Brazil than any other country in Africa other than Nigeria. Now, I love this.
Y'all heard that shit? Y'all heard that? She said it's more Africans in Brazil than it is in any other African country except of Nigeria. That means more Africans in Brazil than it is in Ghana, than it is in Cameroon. Y'all hear this shit? It's called colonization. It's called colonization. If you black, you African. That's why these niggas who running around here still with that black shit in 2022, you niggas are part of the problem. Why? Because you niggas are pushing the colonizer's agenda. You niggas around this hoe pushing the colonizer. Notice, black folks, if you out here trying to find out, I don't give a fuck if you say you a Hebrew. If you a Moor come out and say, I ain't black, I'm a Moor. A Hebrew say, I ain't black, nigga, I'm a Hebrew. I'm from Israel. Black niggas don't like that. Black niggas want you to stay a lost slave. Anytime you're trying to break the chains and go outside of colonization, here come a black nigga. You hate yourself. These niggas are part of the motherfucking problem.
Nicolas Guillen, Afro-Cuban poet. But I only love a little bit of him. He's got a poem, and I never remember his name, and I don't know the rest of it. But cinco nos hermanos, no cinco nos hermanos. Without knowing each other, we will recognize each other. And what I find is, if you look at these indices from Polynesian culture, then they help you recognize phenomena that you find elsewhere. Yesterday, the same words we were talking about, having a language. Well, other African descendants in the Americas also have languages. The Guarani in Central America, in Honduras, Belize, Nicaragua, and Guatemala, they have a language. What is really frustrating to me is that people who study the language look for the Africanity of their language. Yet the word human being is Mutu. Bantu, Mutu, human being. There's Palenquero in Colombia. There are the French Creoles. There are the English Creoles. There are the various languages that you say I'm for, from the Maroons in Suriname, San Marco, Juca. So another jumping off point for understanding the global African diaspora. So I think that we will recognize each other once we get models in our heads. For example, the ring shout. I attended an event on St. Helena Island in 1999, and that's the first place I saw the ring shout. Then when I went other places in the Americas and beyond, I began to notice African descendants dancing in a ring, often counterclockwise, but not always. That's important. So we find similar characteristics. Not that everybody got together and said, how are you going to do it? But interestingly, people are doing the same things. I was looking at my videos. I have a lot of video footage from various places. And I thought, oh, the stereotype is true. We are always singing and dancing. And what's wrong with singing and dancing? But then I read an article written by a Congo, a Mukongo, part of the Bakongo ethnic group that created the Congo Kingdom, that involuntarily created so many people to create the African basis of all of the Americas. And he wrote an article, this linguist wrote an article about Congo's dancing in Congo Square in Louisiana. And he talked about the fact that in French, Fela Bangula, Bangula being a colonial African descended dance, Bangula meant to dance, to party, but also from the French meant create disorder. And Bangula now is a derogatory term in French for Africans and African descendants. In Kikongo, however, Bangula refers to ancestors. And he said what the Congos were saying was, we are dancing so as not to forget our ancestors. We are dancing to remember. And so then if you notice that African descendants are dancing all over the place without having gotten together and said, how are you going to remember your ancestors? Dancing to remember. They've chosen in Paraguay, in Chile, in these are McIntosh County Chowders, 1999 at Penn Center. They had chosen to dance in circles here in the Southeast United States. I will also show you Brazil, Northern Brazil, Maranhão is a circle. I'm going to show you next. I'm going to end with Uruguay, a reenactment of 19th century Congo.
The Spaldings are among 46. To Saplo Island, home for him as a child and generations before him, all the way back to their tortured departure from West Africa. The Spaldings are among many thousands of Americans now reclaiming a culture carved on another continent and preserved with centuries of isolation on the so-called Sea Islands that dot America's southern Atlantic coast.
Well, whenever I come here, I feel rejuvenated. I feel like I'm joined with my ancestors, because whenever I look out on the Atlantic, I can still hear their voices. I can still feel their spirits. So it's a place I like to come to and meditate.
She carries the title Queen Quet. Maqueta Goodwin traded Manhattan and university degrees in mathematics and computer science for a mission on the South Carolina and Georgia Islands, where slave traders brought her ancestors.
Out there in the Atlantic itself, you would have seen slave ships docked, because what they would do is leave the slave ships out at that distance and then take us off, the cargo, the human cargo off, and put us on flat bottom wooden boats to bring you into the plantations, and then people would be brought off in chains. They are celebrating. They are at home. They are on the continent. What continent am I talking about? Okay, so now they are still at home in the motherland, in Africa. They are
appointed as both monarch and mouthpiece for her.
Hey, y'all see this indoctrination, bro? Do y'all see the indoctrination, how heavy it is? Ain't nobody doing no genealogy. Ain't nobody out there asking questions, who you are, where you peeping them from, what's the stories in your family. Nobody asking those questions out there. It's just simple, nigga. If you black, then you're going to get this indoctrination. If you black, you're going to get this indoctrination. You know, your home is in the motherland. And what a motherland, Africa. That's how this shit work.
The people, she wages her battle in schools, at public meetings, in the media. to reinvigorate traditions lost for most Black Americans, but still alive here and known as Gullah.
Well, out of the population of people of African descent in America in general, they estimate some 500,000 to 750,000 that are Gullah, that still speak our language, carry on the traditions, carry on the spiritual practices and so on, and live in our homeland, which is the Sea Islands and roughly 30 miles inland to the mainland. Everything's about rhythm, and it's about celebrating Gullah culture.
Hey, that's how y'all, this y'all learned this in the Sea Islands. This is what they teach y'all down in the Sea Islands. This is how y'all getting down in the Sea Islands.
The rhythm extends to a unique Gullah dialect combining African languages with English. And as you'll see, it's even there as they pray. Unmistakable faces of Africa in the way they greet one another, even in the food many still eat. A culture.
Unmistakable faces of Africa. Unmistakable faces of Africa. You look at these niggas, you ain't gonna make no mistake in thinking these folks ain't from Africa. Turn up, what's up with it, Kyle? Rob Montana in the building. Geechee say they hit them hard in South Carolina.
Just bridging the Atlantic.
So many times people don't want to discuss our culture and who we are, because then to even say who we are means that you have to go to the past, because the past is the present for us. Most of us still live on the very plantations where our ancestors were enslaved to work cotton, rice, and indigo.
I can't do nothing about that.
And so it is on Saplo Island. Many on the Spalding's bus tour are making their first visit.
People don't lock their doors, you know. Vehicles, keys stay in it.
But Stanley Walker is part of a tiny community that lives here. On land their ancestors worked for the slave owner, the man from whom many slaves took their name. Thomas Spalding lived in the big house.
Bad Spirits Plantation House. You can't hardly get nobody that's from Sample.
Goddamn, Scott. That's the face of a Scott. That nigga Scott is Irish. Hey, nigga, Scott is Irish.
In Civil War turmoil 140 years ago, the slaves won much of this land, and their families have held it since.
And everybody wondered what I was going to do. I told them I'm going to do what I do best, and that's talk. And I've been over here talking ever since.
Above rattles in his 20-year-old Dodge van, Stanley talks in part about how hard it is to find a wife on Saplo, everyone's family.
It's hard to find a wife out there, they say, goddamn. I don't want to go out there, Saplo Island. We got any Saplo Island in the building? Anybody know where this at?
Yeah, by the time I got old enough to know, start dating, you know, like, no, you can't talk to this one because your granddaddy, granddaddy had a cousin that married her great so-and-so, and oh man, on and on.
He talks too of the most pressing topic here, developers with big checkbooks.
Yes, they're slowly moving in. They're gonna eventually end up taxing everybody out, and I'll be standing on the dock one day telling my grandkids, you know, I used to live over there, I remember the area I used to play in and stuff like that. It's coming.
So this is important to us. It's like Custer's last stand almost, you know, and we can see the wagon circling. We don't want it to circle.
Cornelia Bailey and Ben Hall are cousins in Hog Hammock, population 70, the nearest thing Saplo has to a capital and the last Gullah settlement on any of the Georgia Islands.
We grew up with being told that a poor person don't have but three things going for them, and that's God, your word, and a piece of land.
They came and sacrificed, they bled, they died for.
Junior said, ain't nothing wrong with a little kissy cousins. Junior said, ain't nothing wrong with a little kissy cousins you got there.
This land, I feel like it's a birthright that I have and that I should never get rid of it myself.
But who take Hog Hammock from them? Here, they insist there are any number of faceless dealers on mobile phones circling Sapler.
Because they are constantly trying to buy property. Yes. In the
constantly.
See, we know they're not buying it just to keep it natural like it is. Because they're in the business of development.
If you doubt developers could warm to Hog Hammock, look at what they've done on other sea islands. Like Hilton Head, they've engulfed it. On this island alone, 24 golf courses, centerpieces in a wildly wealthy playground for some of America's most affluent.
Almost every home on the island is either facing a fairway or a green, or on one of the lagoons. So everything around here is built on golf.
Annual membership to this golf club is $70,000.
I'm a golfer. I get out as much as I can, but it's just really a very pleasant place to play.
Harbour Town is just one of four golf courses inside what they call a gated community, or ironically, a plantation, all behind security.
This plantation, for example, the public can come in, they pay a fee, and they're monitored when they're in here. It gives people a sense of security, plus the fact that the architectural standards are very high here.
Hilton Head is so pricey, it subsidizes police and firemen to live nearby. Otherwise, they, like the Gullah people, would never afford it. The new wealth has built out this small island with what's now ranked America's sixth wealthiest town. The average home here fetches $3.5 million, double Beverly Hills prices. But for all their effort, Hilton Head's developers couldn't keep Gullah culture.
As I drive over the asphalt and the concrete, I can hear my ancestors crying out from beneath it. I can feel a lot of spirits that are unrested there because a lot of grave sites have been disrupted for people to put golf courses and tennis courts and clubhouses and things that are for recreation and no preservation.
Unfortunately, growth and development, I don't think, has been terribly sensitive to them.
It's pushed them out?
It's pushing them. It has pushed them slowly into one section of the island.
Now, hey, that's it. First African Baptist Church, ain't that a bitch? Organized 1859.
Dear Lord, you have always been with this church. You have been with this church for 142 years, dear Father. We want to thank you for that. Dear Lord, we realize...
Nearby, locals and some visitors from Saplow Island celebrate the anniversary of a local church formed in the dying days of slavery.
But right now, Lord, we realize that we've been blessed down through the years. But now, Lord, as we come to this point, bless us now, Jesus. Bless us.
Amen, amen, and amen.
There is the feeling that there will be no more left of the wonderful Black heritage on this island, and we will become just another ho-hum community of golf courses and gated communities, just like the other islands.
Local resident Kay Horton has joined this island's African American community in its fight to put some land beyond wealth, arguing the new money isn't working with old ways.
So they have come in not to be part of the community, but to displace the community.
Once a year, thousands travel from across the U.S. to Beaufort, South Carolina, to celebrate the survival of their links with Africa.
I'm still eating some of the same food that we brought from Africa. Black eyed peas.
You got some black eyed peas from Africa, nigga. Don't tell me you niggas out here cooking the African dishes.
Cow peas.
Cow peas, huh? You got, yeah, you granddad and them, I tell they got to, they like them cow peas, nigga, the purple hood pea. All that shit come out of Africa. You brought it, you braided it in your hair, and you snuck it over for the boat ride. Knew you was gonna get hungry, need a snack. Why not snack on a black eyed pea? Man, that bro is a long, long journey, nigga, coming from Africa, nigga, getting over here to South Carolina, nigga. You don't need a snack. Huh? Better take your little okra. Get you a cup of cow pee, nigga. Tuck them in your pocket. You gonna need them. Where you going?
I think it's one of the most precious thing in the world to me is to be gullah.
Among those at the festival, storyteller Vimel Rodriguez with the quilted account of Gullah history.
The blocks at the bottom of that quilt that represent all of my ancestors, white bleached bones that are underneath that Atlantic Ocean. This time of the year, those bones begin to rack up and they push in the wind and the rain and the rain and the water, everything up in the atmosphere. It's the hurricanes. All hurricanes do start off of the coast of Africa.
They taught y'all this shit. How many of you niggas out here regurgitated this shit before? How many of you niggas out here regurgitated this shit before? Watch this. Can I raise my hand? Yeah, me, Chief. I regurgitated this shit before, bro. You know where I got it from? Dick Gregory. Dick Gregory taught me this shit, bro, and I went out and regurgitated it. That's some crazy shit right here. Yeah, that nigga Dick, ooh, that nigga got me. And the whole time, it's a trick. You ever heard a nigga building on, I remember what tripped me out one time. I was at the Shrine of the Black Madonna, and it was this guy in there, and he was teaching. And all of the shit he was teaching was old school shit. He was like, you know, bunnies don't have, rabbits don't lay eggs. So why are you celebrating the egg for Easter? And this other nigga was like, ooh, I never thought about it like that. And he had him a little crowd over there, a little circle. And he was just saying like a lot of outdated shit. But that one stood out to me when he was telling them about rabbits don't lay eggs. And, you know, country's community mumbo jumbo. You know that shit, you package it up and you can go anywhere around America and the nigga got that same doctrine. But this is a part of that doctrine shit too. That hurricane shit. Because the hurricane mad that the West Africans got took. And so it come and destroy the Americas. Because that's where they took the average. That's the shit they teach us. Had my city ass out here, I can't even regurgitate it. Fucking with Dick Gregory, you motherfucker.
Oh, the world has been very effective at burying Gullah culture. The world has been very effective at burying African culture of any sort. The world has been very effective, especially.
Yeah, Joe Jack, Joe 47, goddamn hurricane pissed the fuck off.
And you know what he told me? He said, and it's always a woman. That's why they always, you know, it's a feminine energy. And then you come out to the goddess Arya. She plays Storm in X-Men. She plays Storm in X-Men. I got a lecture Umar Johnson did in Houston in 2015 that I recorded. And he brought that up about the hurricane and it being Storm out of X-Men and all that, and Halle Berry played. Come on, man. Niggas out here indoctrinizing us. Yeah, D. Gregory said, that's why they name all of the hurricanes after women. And yeah, it was on Brother Rich channel, Black Magic 363. Yeah, nigga indoctrinated us.
Of eliminating thoughts of slavery.
Look at Carrie.
And for all the resilience in Hog Hammock.
That's how y'all doing it out there in the Sea Islands? Hold on, let me rewind that. All of a sudden, I just want to go bike riding. I want to go bike riding in the woods. And then all of a sudden, goddamn, this is how we doing it out there in goddamn me in the Sea Islands.
The resilience in Hog Hammock. There's a feeling among residents the world is about to have its way here, too. The owners of this modest bed and breakfast have broken ranks and put their property on the market. They wouldn't talk with us. Their cousin, Cornelia Bailey, stopped short of using the word treachery, but leaves no doubt she's not following.
There will be a few of us left on this island with a shotgun on our knees, chasing off any developers. I mean, we might be called the activists or the renegade, anything you want, but there are going to be a few of us standing there with money doesn't count. Look, if I can buy a pair of shoes, buy a dozen eggs, and go to the doctor and pay my bills, and I got a roof over my head, what would I want to do with the whole excess amount of money that the government going to take from me anyhow?
Born and raised.
Okay.
Saplow out. Born and raised.
Yep.
For James Spaulding, the return to Saplow is stirring.
We come back and visit again together, right?
Yeah, yeah. Probably will.
All right.
I probably will. I won't doubt that. Next
year. He leaves what may be his last visit home, thinking in terms of restoration, not development.
Well, I don't think you understand. I would care very much, you understand, for that. I would like to see the ancestors, the old ancestors, you understand, restore what has been here before. I really would like to see that happen again.
With many African Americans now celebrating their Gullah heritage and the places where their forebears preserved it, developers may just have to do without the land owned by the last of the Georgia Island communities.
From a businessman's perspective, from a development type thing, it's a tremendous success. I think when you step back and you look at it as a Native Islander, I think there's a touch of tragedy to it.
Hog Hammock or Hilton Head. To a large extent, development has won out in America's Sea Islands.
We feel that if you came and saw this environment in its natural state and you thought it was beautiful, then why isn't it beautiful enough for you to leave it like that and live it?
All right, now we're going to come over here down in the Sea Islands in this area. And this here is a lecture that y'all can get for free on BigChiefUniversity.com. Y'all go over to BigChiefUniversity.com. Goddamn, y'all come tap in with us over here if y'all haven't been over here. We got some new merch coming, bro. We finna fuck the summer up with this new merch. That's about to drop. And don't forget, goddamn, come over here and tap in at 12 Play Playground, goddamn. Fuck that. Hey, before we get out of here, goddamn, somebody come shot. Do we got a link in the chat? Hold on, let me drop that link down there for us, goddamn.
12playground.com. Somebody go drop the goddamn link down there. We got vibrator panties, goddamn, $27. We got the roses down sale with $30, 10% discount, man. We got a south opening. But y'all really need to tap in with these vibrator panties, goddamn, fellas. You want to take baby out, goddamn? Which one of you niggas? See, all you see, some of y'all niggas gotta go sneak and do that type of shit with your side bitch. Baby too conservative. Yeah. Baby too conservative, goddamn. Yeah, man, this how you get her, though. You come get her one of these right here, these vibrator panties, man. And, yeah, you take her out on a date. Y'all go get some nice drinks and all that, and you bring... And then what you do is you hook it to your phone, your cell phone. It's Bluetooth on your cell phone. And yeah, act like you're checking the score on the game and zap that pussy. You hear me? Yeah, so oh, let me send this text. Yeah, y'all come shop, goddamn. Come tap in with us. Somebody drop that link down there. Appreciate that little NG Gal. NG Gal got the link right there. Look at Copper Libra. Yeah, and we got the discounts. You ain't going to find it no cheaper than this here. $27 for the vibrator panties, $30 for the roses. We got the ones that lick on you. We got the roses that lick on your motherfucking ass. And we got the joints that suck on that pussy. Yeah. We got the one that licky, no penetration. And we got that one that just suck on it. Just suck on you. And then it come with the dildo. Got the dildo on the end. You can turn it around, let it suck on you on one end and let it fuck on you. Come on, man. We not finna. Y'all come fuck with us, man. 12 Play Playground. We got the podcast coming soon. We got the shows, the video games. We're going to be doing trivia, doing giveaways and shit. We're going to turn up. Y'all ask for it. Goddamn, it's here, 12playplayground.com. Come tap in with the kid. Come over here to BigChiefUniversity.com as well. Join our community, goddamn me. Genealogy tomorrow. We'll be on YouTube. We'll be rocking out here, goddamn. Y'all make sure y'all come subscribe, goddamn. This is how you show support over here, goddamn. Keep the show going. All right, we're going right here. You get over 600 hours, probably 700 now. Lexus curated by Big Chief, goddamn. We're going to come in here right here in the Sea Islands down there in that same area down there. Yeah, somebody go show love. What the fellas at this on some player shit out there, man? Fellas, go get how you don't want no goddamn. Yeah, come on, man. See these women. I know the women, they want the one, they trying to go get a rose or something. Fellas, get you a goddamn penny vibrator, man. That's really for the brothers. Yeah, get baby and sneak that, slide that on a motherfucking ass, man. When y'all go out. Here, go put this on. I don't really fuck with the panties. I don't like panties on dates. We going on a date and you got on panties, you paying for your own food and drinks. I'm not doing this shit with you. We going on a date, you got on panties and shit. Yeah, we going Dutch. We going Dutch around here. I'll let you have some motherfucking panties on or something like that. Goddamn, we going Dutch. But now we got the panty vibrator, so it's an exception. You understand me? Yeah, play with that pussy while you're driving. Y'all in the shopping malls, and yeah, let's walk. All right, so we right here in the low country. We're in the low country, huh? Let me pull this up, man, get a good look at this. Indians of the South Carolina low country, man. That part. All right. There we go. Hold on, let me try to get it right here. They go Georgia, they go Savannah, they go Hilton Head, St. Philip, St. Helena right there. They go Disto Island, Port Royal Island, they go Paris right there, Charleston, what beautiful that, let me see. They go Kiowa Island,
John James for something right there. All right, let's walk. The Low Country of South Carolina once belonged to more than a dozen distinct groups of Native Americans who existed and now badly remembered. In the decades after founding Charleston in 1670, indigenous people of this area interacted regularly with white settlers from Europe and enslaved Africans transported from the Caribbean. Disease, warfare, and displacement gradually reduced their numbers. However, at first, people of the Low Country were virtually extinct by the middle of the 18th century. Their history now largely forgotten, but their names remain fixed in our modern vocabularies. For example, the early surviving description of indigenous people along the southeastern coast, South Carolina, recorded by French and Spanish explorers between 1562 to 1576, contained references to at least seven distinct communities or tribes. All right. Now, the Eskimaku, the largest of the southern tribe, the Hoya, much smaller, near the Eskimaku, the Edisto on the Broad River, the Tupa Broad River, Mayan Broad River, the Stalum, Port Royal Island, and Coosa, north of Port Royal. All right, here go a map right here. And this is what they called in Pan-African history, Black history, they called it the Gullah Geechee Corridor. Gullah Geechee Corridor, Jacksonville to North Carolina. Jacksonville, North Carolina.
Hold up, I want to go back.
What
hold
is on, it? Chief.
Can I go back a little, brother?
Gullah.
All right. Now, look, check me out. All of this shit right here, bro. We just went through the tribes. And they names that, you know, don't even be mentioned today. But all of this shit right here was home to people. And we just named some of those tribes. And then all of a sudden, I want to show you, though, because this 1700s, now even 16, but coming into the 1700s, you got to understand the English gonna get here in the 1600s, and you had Spanish missions coming through here late 15s, you had Spanish missions and shit like that coming through here with other Indians trying to come up there because they came up there to come get the gold, and you know, they was able to fight them off or whatever. Now we look at it, this shit here is 18, 19, 20th century, bro. I mean, yeah, 18, 19, 20th century shit. But it goes to show you how the times changed, though. Back then, at that point, it's no, you can't bring a conversation about an African conversation don't come into this play until the late 17s. When? The time of the U.S., the birth of the U.S. All right? You got to understand this African story is a story that is created in this U.S. jurisdiction. African story is a story created through the U.S. jurisdiction. That's why the U.S. As a government have to hold on to this narrative in their government, because who are these people? Who is this population? In their record, they have to put them down as African. Gullah Geechee Corridor, goddamn.
Gullah Geechee Corridor, Jacksonville to 18th to 20th century scholar, obsessive 18th to 20th country is member of Carolina. Charleston. Whoa. All right, let's walk. So this is an old depiction of how it used to go down. Many sources published in the past century describe the various tribes and bands of indigenous people of the Low Country as members of a larger collective called the Cosabo. But the modern use of that term is fraught with problems. The collective term Kasabo is an artificial construct inspired by a 19th to 20th century scholar obsessing with classification. Most of these names out here, bro, that motherfuckers are using now are what was put on you through classification. And they doing this shit on, they did it on purpose. But most of this shit is for classification. If y'all remember, we even went through, what was his name? Franz Boas. Franz Boas said, hell, he ain't know the name, he guessed it. That nigga said he put two and two together. He got, that nigga said he had an hour left. He got out of work at 10 that night, man. He was trying to get up out that bitch. But the collective term Kasabo is an artificial.
She hoisted that say we're on what's known as Kuso Island.
Construct inspired.
And them was old, them Indians too.
By 19th and 20th century classification. The people commonly called Indians who inhabited the low country in the 17th and 18th centuries never identified themselves, constituted parts of broad collective of the term Kasabo. And so
let me say this right here. When you hear this Kasabo, these are classifications, bro. Many sources published in the last century describe the various tribes or bands of indigenous people of the Low Country as members of larger collective called the Kasabo. But the modern use of that term is fraught with problems. The modern use is fraught with problems. Why? The author says the collective term Kasabo is an artificial construct inspired by a 19th and 20th century scholarly obsession with classification. Very, very important that we note that. And you be having some Yamasis out there thinking nigga trying to knock what they got going on. But in reality, bro, that shit is a classification. It's a classification, bro. It's not a one band. I mean, it's not a one bloodline of people. It's an artificial construct. Just like Kasabo, which if you're talking about Gullah Geechee, if you're talking about a Seminole, if you're talking about a Yamasi, you gotta throw in Kasabo in there too. Cause that term is no different than the other terms. Except some did have tribal affiliate. As far as the Kasabo, that wasn't what they called themselves or what they used. So let's walk. So basically what we're saying is these are different people coming together, or different people that they have put together. And in order to classify all of them, they use one label to identify these group of people in this certain particular area. Let's walk. In reality, people commonly called Indians who inhabited the Low Country in 17, 18 centuries never identified themselves as constitute parts of broad collective. This collective noun, Kasabo, is convenient handled for conversations about the past, but in this modern, historical evidence when colonists of the early 18th century spoke or wrote about the Native Americans who lived on the coastal settlement in South Carolina, they frequently used some variations rather than generic terms or phrases. And when we come here, hold on. And I want to point this out too, bro. So it talk about the early description of these people, bro. This in 1576. Hold on, where my map at? All right, right here. We'll come to the map. And you better talk to me nicely. Next to blow a little bitch, I might be. Now we're looking in this area, right? This the Low Country.
we looking in this area, bro, and we don't see nobody named Seminole, we don't see nobody named Gullah Geechee, and we don't see nobody named Yamasee. And it's Indians of the South Carolina Low Country, 1562 to 1751, bro. None. These are indigenous names of these people, those in these areas, though. And rivers and the lakes and shit. Is this up here? This is what she talking about? Okay, they go Kuso up there. Yeah, he go the damn map, bro, of the area back then, bro. And we don't see them names on there. All right, let's come up. The geographical range of the conversation embraces what is commonly called the Low Country of South Carolina. That is, the coastal plain stretching approximately 80 miles inland between Savannah River to the south of the Santee River and to the north. If you pay attention, that's what Queen Quet just noted. She always said she had the same spiel. She got the same spiel. That's wild. But I point that out to note that we're talking about the same, you know, it's just, you know, to let you know that we're talking about the same people. Because she calling them African, but we're just going to see what was, you know, what happened to the people that were there. Before the new names and all of this type of shit here, the new names of the places and all this type of shit here, the whole new narrative and story and shit. That's wild. This geographical range encompasses landscape. Let me see. St. Helena served as the capital of Florida from 1566 to 1587. Spanish forces largely abandoned the site and retreated south with the San Augustine. Over the next 20 odd years, Spanish agents sailing northward from the new capital continued to explore coastline of modern South Carolina and encountered different additional groups of indigenous people in the vicinity of the harbor they called St. George or modern day Charleston Harbor. Spaniards met representatives of the three distinct communities they recognized as the Stono. Okay, and nowadays, 1739, the Stono Rebellion, South Carolina. Some people like to associate that with the Yamasee. I have no problem with it. But those people had a name. And it wasn't Yamasee. It was Stono. It was Kiowa. It was the Etowah people. Who associated with the Stono, the Ashley, and the Cooper Rivers, respectively. People down there had names, bro. Names that don't get called a representative today, but you still got Stono out there. You still have them represented in history. And we do know that these Stono people would have been fought or would have fell in that same category as the Yamasee people. We know that because of the early wars and also because of the wars against the Tuscarora. The early wars between the Goose Creek men that came there, the early wars in that Charleston Harbor area. It was Stonos. In the 1600s, they've been fighting the Stonos. So when it come up to 1715, you got the Yamasee War. These the same niggas that's getting into it. That's why in 1739, when they fall out again, and that'll be the last time you hear about these Stonos. 1739, because in 1740, they're going to make them Negro. 1740, they passed South Carolina Negro Act. In response to the 1739 Stono Rebellion. You'll never hear about them niggas again. Or other niggas, these other niggas that was around there. You never hear about them again, because now when we bring them up, they classify, they consider Negroes. And then you got niggas running around here tell you to adopt a Negro or to you black folks is Negroes and all this shit here. You niggas colonized and don't even know it. You niggas colonized and don't even know it. And so, yeah, let's walk. Early visit to South Carolina, return to London. He said the natives, he said they are deep chestnut color. They have black and straight tied various ways, sometimes oiled and painted, stuck with feathers for ornament. Their eyes black and sparkling, little or no hair on their chin. I want to say that again, bro. Now, this is a nigga in 1682 who went to London, who had left Charleston, and he came back and was telling stories about the people that he seen down there. You big beard ass niggas and all that. I can't grow no beard. My beard don't be looking right. That bitch would take about 100 years, nigga, to get me a little, get a little kick on it. I keep telling niggas, all you niggas chest full of hair and all that, that ain't indigenous. What this nigga say? To little or no hair on their chin. We ain't that. Our shit ain't grow like that. Our shit ain't grow like that. You ain't never seen a depiction or oil painting or nothing of American Indian with hair on his chest or a big old beard or nothing like that. You ain't never seen no shit like that, nigga. That's Hebrew law. Ah, that's Hebrew shit, nigga. That's Black European shit. Romans. Yeah, yeah. You niggas, we see you niggas with the statues and the paintings. You niggas got big beards over there, nigga. That's the Bible, King James Bible say, nigga, you got to keep your beard, nigga, and wear your fringes. Yeah. Nappy chest ass niggas. Hairy legs and shit like that, nigga. They go look at them pictures of the tobacco. They got the Indians picking tobacco fields and the Indians on the posters. You got the, you ain't never seen no Indian with no big old beard and no hairy arms and legs and back arms and shit like that. That's Viking blood. You niggas out the Scott, out the Isles of Man and shit. Yeah. No, nigga, we ain't that Scotland. That's Scottish, Viking blood, Norse Vikings. And women like them hairy niggas. They like that European. That European nigga, he like to drink. Yeah, that nigga drink like a fish. Yeah, that nigga say them niggas ain't hell, they ain't wear they shit like I was. That European went back to Europe, bro. They say, yeah, they don't wear they shit out like I was. Them niggas are like they in the Nation of Islam by the face. Yeah, they don't do no motherfucking. Yeah. Them niggas look Nation of Islam, all that shit bald. That shit, they're bald. They don't wear this shit like us. You had the Eskimuga War, the Edisto, the Eskimuga, the Ahia in Carolina, the Wale on the sea coast between the Savannah, the Altamaha River rose up to expel the Spanish. These are your Yamasi, bro. These Yamasi niggas. That's why some Yamasi say that this nigga here, that this was the name of them, but really it was a name of a king, of a chief in that area. But this is, you know, the Edisto and all these are tribes, bro. They islands are still there, but these are tribes. They go to Wale. The Wale motherfucking Yamasi then a sea island nigga, but there is a connection between these niggas and the sea island niggas. Here you go, right here though. Especially their hated missions, they rose up and expelled the Spanish. It ended with Saint Santa Elena to the ground. But all of that shit took place here, bro. 1560s, 1750s, bro. Nobody named Yamasi down there. Nobody named Gullah Geechee. Nobody named Seminole. He go to names, they telling you. And when you go into the history of these, you got Kasabo when you going into them histories.
the Altamaha, whatever the hell. You have to go through these, name these people. Wale, these people are on the table. Gullah, I call them Gullah. They go your Gullah right there. They go your Yamashi right there. Gullah. But they got the Gullah dialect down there, and then you got the Hachidi or Hitchintai, whatever, however you want to say the motherfucker. But these are your connections right here, but it go to real names of these people who live here and who was really affected and who these stories really are about. But they all get lumped up in one. Let's walk. They go Gullah right there. Now here go the towns there. All right, and these are some of the missions that went on. Santa Maria, Santiago, St. Domingo, St. Clara. But this is Wale. You had a lot of them set up there around these areas with, Spanish missions was in the chief towns of some of these people. But these are the people that came out of the area. Here go another map. They go your Aristas right there. They go your Arya. They go your Wale down here. They go to Tamuquin down here. Santa Maria Mission. It's going to go up in that area right there. They're going to start warring. But here go your mission. This is Georgia Sea Islands right here. You got your Georgia Sea Island, you got your Carolina Sea Island. Here you go, right here. This all this shit right here. These niggas talking about Gullah Geechee and all this shit here. These the niggas that was fighting the wars. 1565 wars turned up, nigga. 1570 wars, 1590s. That's where the action was at. By the time we come into the damn 1600s, late 1600s, now you got the South Carolina Sea Island being affected. Then, you know, the British in the Goose Creek, 1670, they going to get there. And now they dealing with these Wale Indians who you had these Westos come down into Savannah, going to push them here. They going to get their guns, and now they coming into the Sea Islands a little more, running more traffic in there. Late 1600s, early 1700s, they going to fall out. You going to see that connection from these niggas in the Sea Islands down here, going to leave from here, and going to South Carolina. All of this going to be a back and forth all the way into what? The Treaty of New York, 1790. All of this 1790, you see niggas signing treaties. What do that mean? Now the U.S. is in play. Now they're signing treaties. 1790, you can't have no niggas running back and forth from South Carolina down here in Florida and all that shit. Treaty of New York. But, you know, and still at this time, nobody's identifying themselves with none of these names. And this is not an African story because they're going to make the treaty with Indians down there. But nobody ever get to talk about these people. These people, you know, fuck them. But these the niggas who been running, who been since the Spanish pulled up, since the French pulled up. These are the people that's been affected by this. Since the British pulled up, it was already a people that's going through these things that these niggas are saying that they went through. I appreciate that love, Eric, in the Cash App. I appreciate that love, family, in the Cash App. All right, we're gonna end it right there. Y'all make sure y'all go over there and tap in, goddamn Big Chief University. Make sure y'all go tap in at 12 Play Playground, goddamn. Fellas, y'all go make sure. Y'all go make sure. Hey, so what's up? You want a link? Hey, come up. I'll drop the link down there.
If you got some resources, homie, right now the time to show them. You talking about speaking on your people? Who is your people? The link in the chat, homie. The link in the chat, homie. You got laughing emojis. And maybe you can come teach us and help us out, brother, because maybe you have some maps that we don't have. Maybe you got some information. You know something that we don't know. Right now be the time to come help us out, brother. Your mosque is, nigga speaking on our people. Maybe you can come help us out. Because right now, and I asked you before to show me your mosque before 1715. Maybe you got that answer today. Or maybe it's Cap. I'm going to go with Cap. I'm going to have to say niggas making this shit up around here. So you ain't going to hit the link. You got laughing emojis in the chat, but you ain't going to hit the link. So it's Cap. Oh, okay. It's Cap. These niggas be with the Cap. Mikey say, who me? I'm going off the Old Testament. The Old Testament. Oh, okay. Niggas be running around here with this old cap ass information. These niggas ain't got no information. We don't do cap around this hoe, nigga. We put it on the screen. We put it on the screen, nigga, just like we just did. Niggas got laughing emojis and ain't got no genealogy. Come on, bro. Laughing emojis ain't gonna get you no genealogy or no paperwork or no goddamn your mosques, bro. That shit cap. All right, anyway, bro, we moving on. Matter of fact, we gonna end it right there. These niggas scared to hit the link and shit. Do no cap and get scared, nigga. Don't jump out there like you gonna jump up. Come on, bro. Then get scared and shit. We ain't on that. But anyway. All right, man. Yeah, man, these niggas know they ain't mean to say. Say, man, we ain't doing no fake tribes, bro. We ain't doing no Dr. York, Yamasi Moore shit. We don't know Dr. York shit. All right, y'all, man, y'all be cool like y'all be cool, man, fellas. Go over there and get the goddamn vibrator panties, man. Go get the vibrator panties, man. Fellas, go get the vibrator panties, goddamn, man. We'll see y'all goddamn tomorrow for genealogy class, goddamn me. Freaky Friday, we turning up. We're going to do some giveaway. We're going to give away a vibrator panty Friday, goddamn. So y'all pull up, man. Come do the trivia with us, man. Y'all be cool like y'all be cool. We gone. Oh,
We'll go to my room of fun. Then I'll say, give me a tongue. Cause tonight I'm gonna fulfill your fantasies, yes. Oh, lie down on the floor. Cannot wait to come.
Need you see this, hey?
Anything that's broken, I'll fix. Spread your legs apart. Feel me, I'm so hard. See, I want you from high.
Oh,
yeah, yeah. Need to climb on top of me. Up and down will go to sea. And that's when I'll go down on my knees, giving you some of my true faith.
Check me out. Which one of y'all fellas out there? Now, I know it kind of fucked up. I'm going to say it in the chat. But we got to do it open. Which one of y'all fellas out there, goddamn? Hey, no sellout. Indian Carter say, how do I hit you up about some of that? Indian Carter, let me tell you something. Let me tell you, any one of you Indians out there, if you niggas get down, if you are into plant-based medicals, listen to me, bro. Y'all like that infused shit, infused mushroom, infused THC and all that shit? Go fuck with no sellout. That nigga Boston George and this shit. Say, man, I'm over here. I say, I'm feeling real good right now. Hey, listen, Indian Carter, bro. I bullshit you not, bro. I swear to God, I ain't bullshitting you. That's on everything I love. This black gelato shit, it's some shit called black gelato, bro. And everything tastes different, bro. Everything got its own flavor, man. But this black gelato, this is my favorite right here. Let me put that to the side. I'm going to bless my game with that. I'm going to get medicated with that a little later. But, yeah, go fuck with the homie No Sellout, man. That nigga Boston George of this shit. That part. Hey, fellas, watch this here. Hold on, fellas, don't go nowhere. Cause see, which one of you fellas, see, cause I want to give away, one of the vibrators. Oh, ladies too. You know what I'm saying? But I wanted to hook one of the fellas up, cause fellas, I want y'all to take somebody out on a date and use the goddamn panty vibrate on them. I want one of you niggas to take somebody out on a date. Peace, what's up with it, man? 2 birds.
What's good, bro?
Oh, slow motion. Goddamn, nigga, where you been at?
Man, I've been in the cup, man, but hey, I got something for you, though, bro.
You got to mute your, I can hear myself in the back.
What's that?
All right, it's probably the best better. What's up with it?
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
All right, yeah, I got something for you real quick, man. Let me snatch up my little cash real quick, man.
Okay, turn up.
Hold on, give me a minute. I'm gonna mute real quick.
All right, all right. Shout out, man, it's the homie Two Birds, goddamn, and pulled up on me. He finna drop something, goddamn. Y'all know he always come through with the Joes, goddamn. Look, 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 look. She hoisted and said, I need some of what y'all talking about. I need some of what y'all talking about, goddamn. Tone 360 said he gonna get at you. Bro, I'm telling y'all, listen, man. If y'all fucking around, the nigga didn't take no shortcuts. It ain't that watered down, bro. And I done had, you know, I had me a good weekend today. They brought me Vegas. They brought me some shit from Vegas down here too, man. God damn. Y'all just, the weed guards, goddamn, was shining up on me this weekend, man. Say, this black gelato shit and that shit from Vegas, stupid. But yeah, man, Denver, Cali, they told me about that Washington, man. I got to fuck with that Washington. Joe Jack, I got to come out there with Joe Jack. Joe Jack going to have me at the sports bar or at a baseball, MLB game with some white hoes. Goddamn, I ain't fucked up about it. They're going to have me out there with some white hoes and MLB gear in Washington. We ain't fucked up about it. We're going to smoke good, though.
Top, top.
Turn up one time.
Hey, yeah, but yeah, I got some cash for you, man. That's you know, we out here in the H Town. They got their thing. They know who they are. You know what I'm saying? So we're gonna go ahead and let them speak on it. And I've been doing my study and everything. I just been busy, bro. You know, I done bought my house and everything. So, you know, it's always love with you, bro.
Yeah, nah, it's always love, man. I was thinking about you probably like a week ago. I'm like, damn, man, what too, bro? I ain't seen. But I know you be moving around. I think last time you having like a baby or something.
Nah. You know I'm an OG, man. I got my grandson now, but nah. Yeah, my daughter just had a baby.
It was something big happening. But I remember you saying you was about to get a house, or y'all was looking into it or something like that too. So yeah, nah. You know I got a lot of respect for you. I know when you gone, you building. You know, in the real way. So you say you got some little homies that's That's coming into the information.
Man, everybody here that's at my job, man. Everybody already know, bro. But here, I'm gonna let them speak. I'm gonna let them lace up. Hold on.
Okay, in a real way. All right, y'all check it out. We live too, goddamn. He say Michigan grow the second best. I ain't know that, Keith Miller. I ain't know that, goddamn. Michigan, huh?
All right, here we go, man. I'm going to let them introduce themselves. We're going to put it on.
Hey, this is me, Pete Pong, Cherokee and Chateau, buddy.
where you from out here in Houston?
Studiwood.
Okay, in the real way. Now it's out of Studio Wood. What Malcolm Moody had in the chat? Malcolm Moody out of Yale Village. He out of Studio Wood.
Who did out of Yale Village?
Oh, my nigga Malcolm. He ain't in here today though, but yeah, he out of Yale Village.
Malcolm. I went to school with him, Malcolm. I don't remember his last name though.
Like, now he older, he an OG though.
He an older cat.
But what's your oral history though? Let him know your oral history. Who told you?
Oh yeah, my grandmother had finished. My Papa Dawson full blood. They from Chapel Hill, Texas. That's where they come from. Know what I'm saying?
You got acres, y'all got land. What y'all got? What's your?
They got land in Chapel Hill. You know, on my mama's side, we got land too. On my mama's side, I need to give her somebody on her side. Cause if we don't have that land like that, I know it gotta be some Indian. You know what I'm saying? Cause it was inherited.
Yeah.
It was inherited from my grandmother's grandfather.
Okay, now here go the next one.
What's up, big homie? My name is Jarvis. I'm Sunnyside.
Oh, wait. What's your surname? Last name, your surname?
Jarvis Turnwell. My people is from Louisiana. My grandma is Cherokee and Indian, Cherokee and Navajo. And my grandfather's Haitian. We got over 593 acres in Eunice, Louisiana. I'm out of Sunnyside, man. Graduated out of South Park, out of Sterling.
In a real way. Y'all riding horses out there?
Goddamn right, nigga. Get it up. Yeah.
Tell them what you got. Tell them you dog and all that. We got horses.
I got 5 horses.
Hog hunting.
About 17 dogs, man. Bullies, pits, whatever you want, I got it.
Yeah, them niggas Indians. Them niggas. Hey, y'all, check it out. It's them Texas Indians right here, man. Live. Man. Real Texas. You see how turned up he got on them horses, bro?
Yeah. Hey, man. No, man. Because if you don't nobody teach you your history, you'll be lost for life. You know what I'm saying? You'll be going off of what they telling you, what a piece of book and a piece of paper tell you. That ain't all what's up. That ain't true. 99% of it is a lie.
And you say, when was the first time you heard you was an Indian? Your family taught you was an Indian?
My grandma. My grandma still believe in her nationality. My grandma don't go to doctors. My grandma don't go to grocery stores. Everything that she eats and from vegetables all the way down to meat, she grow it. Cows, chickens, ducks, whatever, she gonna kill it. My grandma don't go to the hospital. She broke her arm 3 times, broke her hip once. That was the only thing she went to the doctor for, to put screws in her hip.
Tell us in the digits, what would you say, like, what's something natural that she would tell you what the hell? Let's say, like, wingworms. What was something with wingworms?
Fig trees. Take the fig tree for wingworms, man. Take the green figs, rub it on your skin. Aloe vera plant is good for your whole body, for acne, cleaning your hair, lotion products.
What's something that you know that's indigenous, as far as like that your people don't taught you, or that you know that ain't nothing similar to an African, what they do?
Oh, we do.
Whether it's eating or whatever y'all do, hunting or however you do it, what it would be.
Oh, shit. Our greens got dog on me. Our okra got dog on me. You know what I'm saying? My fried green tomatoes and my fish out the creek. It might be gold, it might be catfish. Me personally, I like that catfish and fried green tomatoes and grits. You know what I'm saying?
Top, you see?
Hey, talk that shit. Yeah, you got us turned up over here, guys.
bro, you know I got to come through and bless you, bro. You know how we do it, man. You a good one, man.
See, speaking of, I'm going to turn out green tomatoes.
Hey, what you say? What kind of fish you say you catching out there in the creek?
What kind of fish you say you be catching out in the creek?
It'd be some catfish, some gulls, blue catfish. You got channel catfish, blue catfish, alligator gar, come across a couple of bass, crappie, bluegill.
I wouldn't eat that shit, because I seen my grandpa had skin when it had the head sitting on the pole when you go inside to the cattle.
And I was just, man, I would eat a whole one fish sandwich from both sides. From once for lamb, that's all you get. You're going to get no slab no bigger than your hand. But I guarantee you, bro, when you deep fry that boy, we on point.
Yeah,
on point.
Yeah.
Eat good, live good.
Y'all that gator?
Hey, live off our land. Not no corner stove or nothing like that, man. We all in the backyard picking over corn, collard greens, snap beans, okra, figs, and pecans. Anything we can grow and sell, we was getting. So we ain't really live off no stove.
Nope.
We didn't know what a stove was until soda water and candy came around, and that grandma introduced that to us in church. So we didn't know what that was. Everything was homemade, all the way down from the candles, the soap, cleaning products, medicine, everything, man. My grandma was they called my grandma back at home. The people that don't like us, they called my grandma a witch doctor, because my grandma believed in her inheritance.
Spiritual
inheritance, dealing with medicine and different things to do to make to survive and
sustain body.
Yeah, sustain your body.
That's
so
that's how my aunt Dribble went out. She had breast cancer, and she kept trying home remedies to help her get over and deal with the pain. But one thing she stuck to a lot with dealing with that pain was that marijuana, that THC, CBD. A lot, and that helped her more than a lot of shit that she was doing.
Because the doctor gonna give you some medicine. You got to take this one pill. You got this one pill that's supposed to help you
but you got to take another pill to knock off the edge of the first one.
Yeah.
So you're going to take a third pill to knock off the edge from the second one.
From the side effects.
And you're
going to
keep going on, keep going on, keep going on until by the time you look at your medicine bag, you got about 20 different pills.
Yep.
That ain't going to be right for you. Man, hey, find some old remedies, man. Keep to them. That green alcohol with the little balls in it. Grandma used to shake up, man, and put it in glass water. Keep your skin clean.
Yeah,
you
skin too. Yeah.
Yeah, keep your skin clean.
Yeah, don't go away.
What? You hear him talk?
Yeah, that nigga talking that shit. That's that Indian shit, man.
Man, bro. Hey, I'm telling you, man, you don't even want to know, bro. Hey, tell him how many cats in here. Is everybody in here that's a so-called black? Do they all know, have the Indian story? Have I pulled everybody to the side?
Everybody in our warehouse, man, is we ain't black. It ain't no such thing as black. It's
we all got
some type of Native American or Indian in us to where our family instilled it in us for us. Can't nobody come tell me, hey, you black. Nah, my boy. Yeah, I might got this skin color. My hair might not be black, but it's brown. But you not have to tell me I'm sitting here and my mama over here singing, oh, nah.
Yeah.
Nah.
Yeah. See?
Yeah, don't. My sister.
Tops, everybody up in here, bro. Everybody know this, bro.
My sister don't got no goddamn bottle baseball legs like they legs. Hey, they good. We ain't got no wide foreheads.
Hey, what the homie from Sunny Side?
Nah, we ain't got that.
What you say, bro?
Hey, Sunny Side, watch this here. I got close out there to the wing.
Say again.
You got them African. You had an African community out there in the Southwest.
Yeah.
So is it a difference or is it similar in the cultures to us in the?
Nah, we ain't nowhere near similar. They don't even like us. We ain't nowhere similar to no type of African. Because when you tell an African you from America or anything like that, they don't like us. They don't even like us for the coming of their country. But they coming over here trying to live off us and talking about we the land of the free. But they steady running over here talking about that, but they don't like us. So, but you coming over here, living off our land and our food and all this extra, but you don't like us. You don't want to compare yourself to us. You think you better than us. So at the end of the day, shoot, ain't nobody better than nobody, but shoot, we get it better than them as far as I can see.
Woo, woo, woo.
Turn up. Hey, watch this here, Studi Wood. You brought up that gator. Tell them about that gator for them people. Right, we got people in the East Coast. We got people in California here, Washington, D.C., Carolina. They don't know nothing about that gator, man. Tell them about that gator.
Oh, man, that gator is what it is. You know what I'm talking about? That smoke gator, shoot the skin, and everybody love the skin, but that's right here. You're not going to find no alligator nowhere else. You might find a crocodile, but you find gators. Ain't nobody buying no crocodile skin, no crocodile belts. No crocodile wallets. They buying gator. And you find that gator from Florida all the way to right here to Texas. That's where you find that alligator. And the meat good fried, the meat good baked, but it's off the chain smoke.
Hey, man, y'all got them Houston niggas in this bitch today, man. Them Houston niggas, man.
Stand up. Houston, stand up, man. You
got them Houston prepping,
but I'm out here in the H, man.
All the G's stand up. Yeah. Shit, and them hoes down. God, dog, we're going to do it like that. We in it, man. Living live at five.
Hey, they say they gator meat the best pork. They say they gator jaw.
Hey, say, look, y'all want the best gator, man? Go ahead, look, don't go to no fancy restaurant or nothing like that. Go to New Orleans. Find you one of them rundown shops that's sitting on the side of the corner that don't look like they using the same grease over and over. Go find you one of them.
They got them here. What's the place here?
But they ain't gonna give you the strips gonna look like chicken strips. I'm talking about these strips in Louisiana.
Yeah,
man, they long as your arm and bigger, bro. I'm telling you, one plate you can feed about six to seven people off of one plate. Catfish dinner, you can feed about 10 people. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about thick, long, pretty meat. So all that stuff that they making inside them stores and shipping out to these stores for us to eat. Watch it, man. You're gonna be sick.
Top top.
Yeah. Hey, he came through here. Two birds and turned it up in here. Hey, you got the Houston niggas in the chat going crazy. You got Ken Brooks. Ken out the Southwest, man. You got Khalil out of Greenpoint. Out there, Greenpoint area.
Oh, Greenpoint.
Gun point.
Gun point. Watch out. What you talking about, sharpshooters?
Hey, say,
no, we like Sunnyside Pine. Don't come around playing, man. Hey, we ruthless out here, but we do love each other. So, hey, don't come out here playing, stepping on nobody's toes. Come out here with respect, man. We respect you, too.
That's tribe business right there, man.
Yeah, my nigga Jay, he out of Sunnyside, man. Belford and Scott.
Already, man.
Yeah, Belford and Scott in the real way. But appreciate you, man. We finna go get up out of here. But appreciate you coming through. That's a classic right there, Two Birds. And then it's the Houston Indians. So, you know, I'm really turned up, man.
Hey, I'm going to catch you on the rebound. Hey, fam, I'm going to catch you on the rebound. But I got some more. I got everybody here. I'm going to have them all come on there and give
okay,
them
yeah, yeah. We got to set that up, then. We got to set that up.
Yep, sisters and everything, bro.
All right, bet. You know we be on this time of the morning every day, so.
Yeah, I'll be trying to. I usually catch you later because you know I'm the lead here and everything, so I'm being in charge of everything. So I can't really get the time every once in a while, but there's a time like it just feel right. You know how it worked, man.
Yeah,
you just put it right there.
Yeah, yeah, man. Do it again, yeah. Goddamn. We need another one of them lineups, man. We can run through everybody out there, man, because people need to see it, and you know how that shit motivated. Doing this shit, you be thinking we by ourselves. You know what I'm saying? But everybody waking up, man.
Man, you on, bro. You on, bro. And you know I'm always come through and, you know, give you a shout out and try to give you something, you know, to let the people know, man, that you the truth, man.
In a real way. Appreciate you, fam.
All right, one love, everybody. Feathers up, tribe up, genealogy over everything. We out.
In a real way. You gotta tell me everything, goddamn. Genealogy over everything in a real way, man. With that being said, hey, I want to hold on, before we get out of here. Before we get out of here, y'all see that shit? I want y'all to see that shit first. Y'all just watch that shit firsthand. And I'm telling y'all, bro, it's why this shit is imperative, bro. It's imperative, bro, that we really get this shit together. BCU, bro, if you BCU or you a member of BCU, we gonna start organizing with the members over there. You know what I'm saying? Because we about to get out into the streets with this shit. All right, we about to go to the next level with this shit. The people out there. But the people who goddamn support the kid and, you know what I'm saying, flying under the BCU banner, bro, we gonna put a lot of more of our focus on BCU. Just BCU, bro, because it's a lot of motherfuckers who benefit off of BCU that's not BCU. You know what I'm saying? And that's not helping us. So we gonna have to put our energy towards BCU, bro, and the people that's there, the people who've been there, and you know, we gonna organize with each other. And so this shit gonna be different, bro. Y'all don't need social media platforms, y'all in these other places, bro. Y'all fly the BCU flag over there. Let niggas know we finna start taking this shit out to the world. You know what I'm saying? We got a message, goddamn. A lot of people want to hear. We finna push this shit forward, the information and the waking up. You know what I'm saying? We finna really get out there. That right there was just prime example, bro. I'm talking about the person next to you, homie. The person in the corner store. The person in the grocery store that just walked out the aisle with you, man. Like, people have this information in them. Nobody never said nothing. Or a motherfucker never had an opportunity to talk. These niggas went straight in. Off the fly, just running it. Real Indian shit. And guess what, family? Let me tell you something. These niggas ain't been in no classes. They ain't been in no lectures. They ain't been on the internet with this shit. But guess what? They are saying the same thing that we're saying. See how this shit work? They saying the same motherfucking thing that we saying. That shit, they're cold, bro. Everything that we were saying, bro, I know one of the first things I came out here, I was running around this whole time about, nigga, indigenous culture, nigga, Indian culture is indigenous culture, nigga. Country culture is indigenous culture to North America, nigga. Because of how a nigga was raised. We was raised in Indian customs. We raised in this culture. The culture that we raised in this shit, nigga, our people, you know what I'm saying? They Indians. Shit, them niggas ain't need no help. Them niggas came and dropped out the tribes automatically. Motherfuckers been walking around with this information. Ain't nobody gave them a platform. Society didn't accept it. Nowadays, motherfuckers coming out and saying, I want to tell my story, man. And it's a beautiful day, bro. That's even more reason for us to goddamn really get in line. All this separated and all that, that's cool, bro. We moving on without it. We just gonna organize with BCU. Fuck all the extra shit, the extras and all of that, bro. If a nigga ain't throwing up BCU, bro, you know, hey, it is what it is, bro. We gotta focus on what we focus on. You know, a lot of motherfuckers been winning. I remember when we cut off shit off last year. You know, we cut it off last year, nigga, and then look what happened. We gotta, nah, fuck that shit, bro. We gonna focus on what we got going on, bro. We gonna push our line. All these different Indian agendas and all that type of shit there, nigga. Our motherfucking message was moving this shit, nigga. All this other shit, something like it, different. Nah, fuck all that. We finna put this bitch down how it's supposed to go. Run right through this shit, nigga. Finna run right through this shit. We finna tap in the youth and everybody. The youth had these stories and conversations and shit like that, too. Yeah, we finna take this shit to a whole nother level, man, in the real motherfucking way. With that being said, man, y'all be cool like y'all be cool, man. I love y'all. As long as we got each other, we don't need no motherfucking body else, goddamn. Hold the motherfucking line. Y'all be cool like y'all be cool, goddamn. And we gone.
Can I tell my son of street nigga? Can I tell my son? On the block from 9 to 5, we getting paper. In the middle of the jungle with that burner on me. For them long nights, we cry cause we had nothing. Look, I just want that money. Stole them honey from me. My partner lost his mind when he switched sides. Now he crossed the line. But I just want that bread and niggas want me dead, yeah. But fuck about what they said, I'm getting fucked already. It's like they wanna take from me. Ever since that I came, they put dirt on my name. In public, they don't say nothing. Cause they know I'm with the shit. This 40 came with a big eight. Came up from nothing, from that 2 pieces of chicken. But niggas, I love, they hate the fact that I'm getting rich. But what goes around, comes around. Gotta watch my back cause they plotting to gun me down. I'm going through this day after day. I can't be real with you bitches, I would've killed for my niggas. It's funny how people change, all change, change. And it's the story of my life, cross my heart and hope to die. And I'ma keep it games until the day I die. And I can never be a snitch without no paperwork, they telling lies. And nigga, this time, oh, I'm pulling up his homicide, I'ma shut it down. And I know they gon' hate on 3-4. Whenever they think they be playing crazy, but fuck that little 380 F&N in my jeans. When I unload, shoot this bitch and aim it. Yeah, let's fuck who how he came and hope they hide it on me. And bitches, I'm a sign when I get loud. Just don't testify. Niggas plot on me, get shot in they sleep. Solo mission, I'm gone. Give a fuck who rock with 3. All I got is me. I did this shit on my own. They say wrong. That nigga did it. Niggas ain't getting it like they say they live. Sound like a bitch in some messy whole business. Won't catch me rhyme with a messy whole with. It's a collision. Love my religion. Elijah Muhammad till I know I'm with it. Due to the fact that my soul is so wicked. Break on a bitch. I got hoes on restriction. I'ma keep it games until the day I die. And I can never be a snitch without no paperwork. They telling lies. And nigga, this time, oh, I'm pulling up his homicide. I'ma shut it down. And I know they gon' hate on 3-4. Whatever.